Grease 2 ain't the word, ain't the word, ain't the word. It ain't got move, ain't got feeling. Bow, 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 wow. Grease 2 ain't the time, ain't the place, ain't the motion. Grease 2 ain't the way that I'm feeling. Grease Lightning, go Grease Frightening. Hello, my fellow YouTubers and subscribers, and welcome to my latest rant! The rants are back! And this is the first rant under the new channel name, so enjoy. Grease 2! I'm purposefully holding my hands this way. Grease 2, the sequel to Grease. Though you wouldn't think it's a sequel because, well, none of the characters from the first movie are in it, apart from one. Released in 1982 and directed by Patricia Birch. Well, I'd say directed. So, Grease 2. As we know, the first Grease was very, very successful, and I reviewed it recently because of Olivia Newton-John's passing, rest in peace by the way. So I thought, well, might as well kill two birds with one stone and actually look at the sequel, because I'd never actually seen the sequel because everyone said it was shit. And you know what? They were right! Grease 2 is a terrible film, but before I go into why it's terrible, I'll give you the plot, or, well, if you can call it a plot. A British student at a 1960s American high school must prove himself to the leader of a girls' gang whose members can only date greasers. So basically, it's more of the same. It's another high school romance, only this time there's a British dude in the main character seat. Yeah, this guy called Michael is in love with one of the pink ladies known as Stephanie, played by, surprisingly, Michelle Pfeiffer. I had no idea she was in this film. And he pretends to be this biker American greaser guy in order to win her heart. And it's essentially, it's the love story between the two of them. There's also other subplots going on. There's other characters who have other romances, and it's really hard to know who's with who. And there's also a talent show story going on as well. Basically, it doesn't make sense. So as I alluded to just now, I think this movie is absolute shite. This is the dog's bollocks of musical movies. I mean, okay, it's not quite as bad as Cats. I mean, it's not that bad. But, oh, Grease 2. This movie is a mess. It is a fucking mess. Talk about a clusterfuck of bits that don't make any sense. At least with the first movie, it was simple. There wasn't much of a story, but at least it was charming, and it made sense, and it was very linear. It didn't have all these fucking subplots going on, which detracted it from being a good experience. No, it had all of those things, and it had great music to substitute that. Like, I don't care about half the characters that are in this film. Where are the other characters? Why do they have to set this in a high school? They're just rehashing the first one. It's just basically... It's a crappier version of the first one. That's all it is. I have no clue why they made this movie other than nostalgia and money. That's the only reason. Like, I don't care about this love story with the British guy and Michelle Pfeiffer. I don't care. I mean, despite the performances, I mean, they try. I'm just not invested. I could not get into this film. There's also, like, two or three other romances with characters that you don't care about. And then the talent show stuff, which, why are they putting on a talent show? Like, there's nothing adds up. My problem with this movie is that it's so incoherent. Like, something that should not have been this incoherent. It should have been so simple. It should have just been a love story, much like the first one. But they've added all this shit around the narrative to compensate. You've got this rivalry with the greasers and the bikers. You've got all these romances. You've got the central romance. And then Michael, the British guy, is disguising himself as a biker to win the heart of Stephanie, played by Michelle Pfeiffer. And the talent show as well. And then there's all this stuff about coming of age, like there's this sex education class. And oh God, it is a mess. It's so fucking... I mean, convoluted is one word for it. My God, like, how... Why did they have to make this such a mess? I don't know how the hell something with such a basic narrative ended up being this. I really don't get it. I don't get how it ended up being such a mess. And to add to this frustration, the songs are crap as well. The one about them going back to school, fine. You know, the final song is sappy and cheesy. You know, it's like, we'll be together. You know, that one's okay. You know, you can kind of pass off most of them, but I can't remember half the songs. There's some really weird ones, especially the one in the sex education class, which is the one about reproduction. I mean, Jesus Christ, it's hardly appropriate for this, for a family audience. I mean, as far as I know, this film was targeted towards families, but I could be wrong. There's another one where two characters are inside a pretend war bunker, and the guy is trying to get his girlfriend to sleep with him, and he kind of tricks her into sleeping with him, and the song is about doing it for their country. Like, what? It makes no sense. And it just baffled me. I watched this film, literally, the film just laid on screen and did nothing for me. I mean, it's not horrible, it's not offensively bad, but it is just nothing. There is no story, it doesn't make any sense. The only good thing I could say are probably some of the performances. Like, Michelle Pfeiffer is good in her role. I can't believe Michelle Pfeiffer's in this shit. God, she's better than this, man. Why is Michelle Pfeiffer in this movie? The only cast member that returns is Dee Dee Conn, the one that plays Frenchie. She's fine. I mean, she has, well, basically a prolonged cameo role. And I don't know if any of the teachers actually return. I think one or two of them might. It is set in the same high school. But other than that, there are no connections to the first film whatsoever. They don't even have the Grease song in this movie. There's no Grease is the word, is the word. I mean, there's nothing like that in this film at all. And it suffers because of that. It doesn't feel like the first movie, but then in the flip side, it also feels, the story feels too much like the first one. So there's no balance with this, and that's why I can't make heads or tails of this movie. That's why it's such a mess, because things happen in this film that don't make sense. It is literally a hodgepodge of bits and pieces. Literally, it just feels like it's moving from point A to B without any sense of cohesion. You know, we're just going from one song, one set piece to the next, and I don't give a shit, you know. That's the problem. I don't care about this movie, and I don't think this movie cares about this movie either. The direction is so bad, it's so lazy, that it's just like, it just gives up, and it's like, fine, let the movie direct itself. It's like the director didn't even turn up to the set. It's like they not only started filming without a completed script, but it looks like they finished filming and editing without a completed script. That's how bad this movie looks. It looks sloppy. At least it doesn't look cheap, I'll say that. At least the budget is on screen, but they haven't spent it very well. Props to the cast, because they look like they're enjoying themselves, and I'll admit some of the choreography is pretty good as well. And I do like some of the costumes that are in the talent show. They are quite amusing to watch, but God, this movie is just under 2 hours long, but it feels so much longer. It's such a drag to sit through. It really is. I just don't care about any of this shit. Literally, the first Grease movie is great for what it is, and it stands fine on its own. You don't need this shit. Don't waste time on this shit. I watched this on Paramount Plus, so I didn't necessarily have to pay for it. I mean, I have to pay for the streaming service, but that's beside the point. And this, again, the script is nothing. Like, it's dull. It's completely dull. Nothing. I mean, the characterizations are more of the same than what you see in the first movie. Like, you've got the pink ladies and the greasers are always combing their hair. And then this time you've got there's also this plot with the bikers as well. Like, there's this rivalry between the greasers and the bikers. And the bikers turn up every so often to disturb the peace, I guess. I don't know why. It's never explained. It's a fucking mess. So, overall, Grease 2 is a disaster. It's terrible. There's not much that really redeems it, to be honest. You don't need to see it. Like I said, I'll give it this. The acting is good, and some of the choreography is good, but that's all I can praise it for. I really don't think that this movie deserves to be called Grease 2. It feels more like a spin-off than an actual sequel, despite the fact that Frenchie returns, but she needn't have bothered, because she doesn't elevate the movie at all. So as for a final rating for this movie, well, I'm going to have to give it 1 out of 10. To be blunt, but that's just my opinion. I mean, if anyone actually likes this film, let me know, because as far as I know, it's universally hated. But I did check on IMDb. There are actually some surprisingly positive reviews for this film. I personally don't get it, but to each their own. And I'm guessing because this movie was so bad, they didn't make a third one, which, thank God, because it would have been more of the same. What more can you do with Grease? There's, you know, if you would have taken it out of the high school, maybe I would have been more interested, but yeah, sorry, not my thing. So, that is my review of Grease 2. What do you think of this film? Please comment down below, let me know. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for future content. And stay tuned for more reviews to come in the future. So until next time, I am Payjack's Perspective. See ya. Bye for now.